Lodge, and I'm here really to talk about the storyline, The Macra Terror, which I filmed with Pat Troughton. My chief memory of that is the location filming. I did do quite a lot of sequences in studio, which I'm far hazier about, but the character Medoc was heavily involved in some location filming in in Dunstable, in a quarry in Dunstable, much used, I think, for Doctor Who sequences. And it entailed going out and filming on a very grey, bleak, miserable day, very, very atmospheric for the episode concerned, but not a lot of fun for the performers. And, of course, in the quarry there were lots of crevices and holes where rain had gathered, and the director, John Davies, had the bright idea that it would be very good for some sequences if we splashed our way through these cold pools of water, wearing a very slight costume, very, very, very slight from my memories of Doctor Who costumes in this particular instance. And sounds a miserable experience. In fact, it was actually quite enjoyable, because my other memory of that is that in those days the BBC were, perhaps they weren't on such tight budgets, they were very very happy to very handy with the brandy when it came to cutting the action and getting ready for the next sequence. So we'd be wrapped up warm in towels by the wardrobe people, and out would come the BBC brandy bottle to warm the cockles, and off we'd go again. So as the afternoon went on, it really became not a grey day at all, but really quite an enjoyable experience, I have to say. The Macra Terror was the last Doctor Who story to be written by the author Ian Stuart Black, who had previously written the consecutive stories The Savages and The War Machines for William Hartnell's Doctor. Incidentally, The Macra Terror was the first story to feature a new title sequence, one that showed the face of Doctor Who in the title sequence, something we now are very familiar with and perhaps think of always having been the case, but that was the first time that the head appeared in the title sequence. Only one full-size prop was ever built for The Macra Terror. In the final episode, where it had to represent the lead Macra, it was changed from what had been a black figure to a white one, totally repainted for that sequence. Incidentally, I had not remembered and had to be reminded that the character of Chicky was played by two different actresses. Now, I excuse myself because I died in episode 3, and the part was originally taken by an actress called Sandra Bryant. A more attractive offer of work came along in the interim between episodes 1 and episode 4, when the character was to appear again. The BBC very kindly released her for that offer, and in episode 4, her part was played by a totally different actress called Carol Keyes. I apologise about Carol Keyes, but as I say, I wasn't there during episode 4. If somebody hadn't told me that, I wouldn't have recollected it, I'm afraid. The four-part story was transmitted from the 11th of March to the 1st of April, 1967. I was 30 at the time. So, yeah, this is really going down memory lane. Although the Macra Terror itself no longer exists, we are fortunate that a few short clips have survived. Some from a fan who filmed brief excerpts from the story on a cine camera. Others are clips cut by Australian censors, which have now come in useful. We're also fortunate that a full set of telesnaps have survived. And this loose canon reconstruction utilises all the available material to retell the story. The story is set on an Earth colony in the far future. When the Doctor, Jamie, Ben and Polly arrive, they are welcomed by the people of the colony, all of whom seem to be living an absolutely idyllic existence. All except my character, Medoc, who gets accused of suffering from delusions when he talks about huge insects taking over the colony. But, as the Doctor is soon to discover, Medoc may be the only one not suffering from delusions.